great. I think I saw you like 5 or 6 years ago at the other show. You look better now than you did 5 or 6 years ago. How is that possible? What are you doing? What's going on?
I feel good.
Well, there you go.
I'm working good.
You feel good, you look good.
Do I look good?
Yeah, you look great. What did I say? I said you look good.
Thank you very much. you did again.
Yeah, you look great. You're in this country for several different things, not just to be here on the show. What else brings you to the United States?
Well, actually, I'm here because of your show.
Right, thank
you. Right now, this minute.
Sure. Concorded in.
Oh, how is that fun?
Great. Yeah, it's great.
Scary, though. It's a little scary.
Well, 3 hours, 20 minutes, or 3 hours, 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Pretty good. And then I'm going to do the Golden Globes Saturday.
Yeah.
I'm presenting an award.
What award are you presenting?
Well, I'm presenting an award that I should have got. I thought that Robert Duvall and I should have got split the award between us for wrestling with Ernest Hemingway, but we didn't get nominated, so I'll be giving our award to somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
That's okay.
Yeah. You have some experience with that event, I would guess. You've probably been nominated yourself many times, been a
I think I've won two.
You've won two? Yeah.
I've won two, and I presented... Can I tell you a funny story?
No, please don't. Save that for the cab ride home.
Well, I presented... I haven't been asked back. It's the first time I've been asked back in the Golden Globe to present, like, for... I think over 10 years, I was asked to present 10 years ago the Best Actress Award.
Very prestigious.
Very prestigious.
Yeah.
And I'm in the Beverly Hills Hotel, drunk as I was in those days, very drunk. And not, thank you, thank you. You don't know what I'm missing. I haven't had a drink in 10 years, and I'm dying.
But no.
Nothing to be proud of.
No, you feel better, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
You feel much better.
But I present this award, and I'm in the bar, and John Cassavetes is there, and he says, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm presenting this award." He said, "Oh," he said, "Gina Rowlands." He was married to Gina. He said, "Oh, Gina is up for that award." God, he said, "I hope she wins it. I love her. She's a great actress." I said, "You wanted to win it?"
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "Yeah." I said, "She's won it." What do you mean? I said, "I'll just take out the envelope and I'll open it up and say Gina Davis, Gina Rowlands, and put it in my pocket, and that's the end of it." She came up. He said, "But wait a minute. I said, "You want me to do it?" He said, "He was drunk too." So he said, "Yeah."
Yeah.
He said,
"Yeah." It sounded okay to you guys.
He said, "Yeah, do it." So I went to bed, barely, and he went to bed, barely, and the next morning we woke up, and suddenly I met him, and he said, "Wait a minute. What did we say last night?" I said, "Gina's going to win the award." He said, "No, wait a minute. No, look." He said, "Don't do it." I said, "Don't worry about it. She's going to win the award." He said, "You're fussed." Well, they won't know till it's over.
Yeah.
The next day, it'll be exposed that I made a mistake, or couldn't read, or I'm dyslexic, or something, I read the wrong name. Don't worry. I said, "Don't worry about it." Now it comes, and he's sitting at the front table with her. And I come out, my name, I take out the envelope, and I said, "And the winner is," and I'm looking at him, and he's sitting there going, "Look." No. And I said... "And the winner is Gina Rowland." She wouldn't move. She didn't know whether to get up or not, and he wouldn't get up either. And I said, come on. So they get up, and she doesn't know whether to accept the speech. Her acceptance speech has been ruined. Everything has been ruined. And I put it in my pocket. I said, "Well done." And so now we're walking off afterwards, and he said, "Who won it?" I said, "Faye Dunaway won it." And he said, "Faye Dunaway?" Yeah. I said, "Faye Dunaway won it for Network, but don't worry about it." He said, oh my God, how am I going to tell Gene? I said, "Don't worry about it." Well, anyway, I know he was so upset that night I got this huge, big thing of flowers and champagne, and I took the card that the winner's name was on the envelope, and I put it inside, and I sent it up to his room about 4 in the morning, and he opened it, and of course, was...
Yeah.
Gina
That's
Rowland.
A great story.
I mean, she actually won it.
You should. We should do something wacky like that this time. Goof around with it this time. You know, Richard, I'm looking at you in the monitor. What do you got going here? What is this? What exactly are we... It's like you got a kind of a, I don't know.
A rugby shirt.
A t-shirt and a tie.
It's a rugby shirt and a tie. Well, I tell you what. When I'm in London, I live in the Savoy Hotel. And they're very snobby.
Uh-huh.
And I wear rugby shirts and old clothes and this and that. But you can't come into the Savoy Hotel without a tie.
Oh.
Right? So I just stick a tie over my rugby shirt.
Yeah.
And I get in. It's very funny. You know what they say?
You know, whether you're drinking or not, you're still trouble. Doesn't make any difference.
It just has nothing to do with the booze. We're gonna do a commercial. We'll come back here with Richard Harrison.
I saw the Unforgiven about a year ago, half a year ago, I forget when it was. And you were great. You play the character, is it English Bob?
English Bob, yeah.
Man, that was a great...
I like that.
It was a great movie. Every little scene was like a chapter in a book. It was had so many different colorations and interesting things in it. It was just great fun to watch.
It was a great movie.
And then at the end, after you're waiting for it, you know Clint is going to go nuts. And man, when he goes nuts...
No one goes nuts better.
Exactly.
And more controlled.
Yeah.
Than him.
That's right.
Yeah.
What else can we talk about your life? You don't drive?
Yeah,
Is it possible that a man of your age and your position in life does not drive his own car?
Well, I got my license suspended for life when I was 19.
For life?
Yeah. I knocked over a double-decker bus in Dublin when I was 19. That was impossible to do, but it did. It fell against the lamppost like this. And the judge said to me, I'm taking away your license for life. He said, when you come to Dublin in future, he said, take a helicopter and come, he said, and come over so you can fly over red lights, buses, and pedestrians. Uh-huh. And he took my license away. But I tell you, I've driven a car. I was in Dublin once. You know, the wonderful phrases, the Irish are very... I talk about Irish playwrights and so forth, the wonderful sense of language. I was driving a car in Dublin. I shouldn't have been driving it. I borrowed it. It was an old wreck. And I was drunk.
Borrowed?
An old wreck. And I shouldn't have been driving
it. Borrowed it or stole it?
Well, okay. You got it right. So I'm driving it, and we come to a traffic lights. And the traffic lights was red, which meant I shouldn't go forward.
That's right. Very good. Yes.
Got that. So the engine cut out of the car, and then it went orange, which means I should get ready to go, and then it went to green, and as it went to green, I tried to get it going, and the car stopped again. So then, when I got the engine going, it turned to red,
yeah.
Means to stop,
yeah.
Then it stalled again,
yeah.
Then it went to orange, and so forth for 15 minutes, I couldn't make it move. And there was a huge, big Guinness truck behind me. And this driver got out of the Guinness truck, and he knocked at my window. And I turned the window down. And he said, is there any particular shade of bloody green you're waiting for? True story.
Oh, God. And then you got out, and you knocked his truck over. I have a lot of admiration for you because you've given up drinking. And we don't mean to make light of people who drink to excess because it's not a good thing. And you're to be applauded for overcoming that. But I didn't mean literally applauded. But when you were drinking, I'm guessing you drank with great abandon and gusto.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So
oh, yeah.
What was your drink of preference?
Well, I used to drink, I'm told, 2 bottles of vodka a day.
you're told?
Yes.
A day?
Yes.
And your day would begin with eggs, toast, and a bottle of vodka?
The day would begin with a Bloody Mary with a double vodka around 8 o'clock.
And then just nonstop.
And just nonstop, yeah.
Nice.
I love it. It was great. I loved it.
And
I missed it. I loved it.
And your buddies, did you ever work? Could you work while you were drunk? Could
yeah,
you ever perform?
Badly.
Yeah.
I worked with O'Toole, and he was the same.
Yeah.
I worked with O'Toole down in Bristol once, and we were doing a play in Bristol. And we had 15 minutes when we weren't on stage, and somebody else was doing the acting. And O'Toole and I knew a little pub just opposite the stage door.
15 minutes, you don't want to waste that valuable drinking time.
No.
15 minutes.
Are you kidding? Let's go, Peter. Boom, out the door. And we were throwing back, and now we're drinking pints of Guinness that time. Drinking back pints of Guinness. And suddenly the stage manager came rushing and he says, for Jesus' sake, you're off. You're off. What? You're off. They're waiting for you to come on. There's silence on stage. The other actors can't improvise. Get up. So we dash across the stage, and we dash across, and we duck sidestep cars, and we dash up into the stage, and I make an entrance per script about a minute, about a second before O'Toole.
Yeah.
So I'm just getting on, and I hit the stage, and I tripped over a large wire, and I fell on the floor of the stage, and I slid right down the stage, and my head hung over the footlights onto the lap of an old 60 or 70-year-old Bristolian woman who looks at me, and she said out loud in the silence of the theater, "Good God, Harris is drunk." And I said, "Madam, if you think I'm drunk, wait till O'Toole makes his entrance."
Yeah. You're nuts. You're like a kid. It's great to see.
You had Duval on here, didn't you?
Yeah, Robert Duval was out here. Robert Duval was in the wings, giving me the finger.
He's giving me the finger. He's the best, isn't he?
The movie is Wrestling Ernest Hemingway, and opens on Friday in this
21st.
Country. Yeah.
Isn't he great?
He's terrific.
Because he asked you, I'm not going to tell you. Because on the show, he said, when Harris comes on, ask him about the little black bag.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to tell you about it. You haven't asked me yet.
No.
Obviously, you're not going to work.
No, I was not.
Dead right.
Would you tell me about the little black bag?
Well, the next time that he comes on your show, ask him about the 5'11" inflated rubber woman, your doll, that I put into his bed.
All right.
I threw it.
Okay. No. Okay. Ask you about the bag, ask him about the doll. All right. You know, you guys could save me a lot of trouble exchanging letters.
Can you imagine letters on the one movie? What'd you say?
I see you could save me a lot of trouble if you would pick up the phone and talk about this stuff with him. It's good to see you. Have fun out there in California with
Thank
the
you.
Golden Globes, and good luck with the movie. And do me a favor, anytime on your way back home or whatever, come back and see us again.
I'd love
You're
to.
Terrific, as
Thank
always.
You. Thank
Rich,
you so
Richard
much.
Harris, ladies and gentlemen.